China has become a net seller of U.S. Treasury bonds and Treasury notes. What that means is that they're selling more Treasury notes and bonds than they're actually buying. So I'm going to talk about what that means to you and me. I'm also going to talk about young workers, the lost generation, lost decade. Young workers who have struggled to get a job in this hideous job market. If I mean more than your eyes, I guess you're right. If I wake up in your mind. Hello, it's September 7th, 2009. I'm Reginald, also known as DemCad. First, young workers, a lost decade. This is a pretty interesting article. It's actually by the AFL-CIO. And basically, they did a study and they found out that 1.7 million fewer teenagers and young adults were employed in July than a year before. So basically, we're hitting a record low of 51.4%. We're seeing young workers get hit harder than anybody. According to the survey, 31% of young workers report being uninsured. 24% reported the same thing 10 years ago. So that's up 7% from 10 years ago. 73% of the uninsured say that they don't have coverage because they simply can't afford coverage. So what this means is that young people are coming out of college, they're coming out of high school, and there's no work for them. This is really dangerous for society because if you have a bunch of young people who can't find work and a political system that is corrupt, you know, essentially you have a recipe for a really ugly term, a very ugly period, you know. At some point, people are going to start to rebel. And I think that if people see that there's no incentive to go to college or there's no incentive to really play by the rules, then eventually they're going to say, hey, I'm going to make my own rules. And I think that's going to be related to the crime aspect of things. And uncounted workers, the jobless reports, unemployment rate. Again, some of you people don't really understand that number. When the media talks about the unemployment rate, they're talking about the U3 number. Okay, that is one of the government's measurements for unemployment. But that number is not compatible, that method is not compatible to the 25% depression number that you hear a lot. Because the U3 number, unlike that 25% depression number, does not include discouraged workers. It does not include part-time workers who want to work full-time. Frankly, a lot of them need to work full-time. You have people working part-time who need to have a full-time job to take care of their two kids, you know. Those people are completely excluded from the system. You know, people who are so discouraged that they stop looking. Now, just because they stop looking doesn't mean they don't want a job. It's just every time they go on a website, or every time they go out to some location and talk to people about a job, they're told that, well, you got to go to the website. You got to go to the website. They go to the website, and there's nothing there. You know, that's what happened to me when I was in Flint, Michigan. And eventually, I joined AmeriCorps in January 2008, and I worked at a high school for a year as a volunteer, and I got a seasonal job at Revilla High School. And, well, now I'm in the middle of doing something right now. I'll tell you about that in another video, but, I mean, it's pretty tough, you know. You play by the rules, you go to the college, you get the degree you need to become what you want to become. In my case, it's a juvenile probation officer. Maybe I'm going to be an adult probation officer. But you get that degree and the states start cutting their budgets. So anyway, China. That's another important thing I want to talk about. China, it's becoming a net seller of U.S. Treasury notes and bonds. What that means is that they are selling the U.S. dollar more than they're buying it. Okay. This is very important. They hold, I think they hold over $1 trillion in U.S. Public debt. Actually, in 2006, China and Hong Kong accounted for 50%, for a more than 50% increase in the amount of treasury debt sold to the public. In 2008, their share had fallen to 22%. Now think about that, 50 to 22%. Now, this is as the U.S. government increases debt by a record $1.2 trillion. And in the first half of 2009, this year, Hong Kong and China acquired only 9% of all or more of the $800 billion worth of treasury bonds. So basically, you're seeing the number shrink. And June, they became a net seller. So think about that. 50, 22, 9. Now they're selling. Now you know what's going to happen with the U.S. dollar. The Republicans are getting angry over Obama's speech to the kids. And look, it's just a speech. I think it's just a protest over who Obama is and what he's done. What he represents. So I don't think the speech is really the problem here. It's people are just angry with this guy. And I don't think it's just Republicans while I'm talking about the issue. I think it's funny that he's being accused of socialism. It's not really socialism if you're merging state power and corporate power. The president's firing a CEO, that's not socialism. That's corporatism. And corporatism is a component of fascism. Anyway, thank you for watching my video. Please rate it. Please comment. I definitely read them all, even though I don't comment on every comment. Okay, so bye.